share my videos with your friends and score more in NEET, CET and board exam. And keep watching, subscribe my channel and press bell icon. Thank you friends. Student, let's see the most important topic of biology, that is the nervous tissue. Here, nervous tissue is made up of two types of cell, neuroglial cell and nerve cell, or which are also called as neuron. Neuroglial cell, these are the supporting cell. Their function is nutrition. They support the nerve cell and they are having ability of division. While nerve cell, they lack the ability of division. Means they do not divide. If they get damaged, they do not divide. If your skin get damaged, at that time new cells are produced. But if nerve cells are damaged, they are not produced as they are unable to divide. Let's see the structure of nerve cell. Nerve cell consists two important parts. This part is called as cytosol, or it is also called as pericardium, or it is also called as cell body. And this neuron, it also consists processes. The short processes which arise from this neuron, they are called as dendron. And a single large process arises, that process is called as axon. These are the two main parts of the neuron, that is cytosol and processes. Let's see the cytosol. Cytosol, it consists nucleus. Then it also shows nucleolus. And it shows basophilic granule, they are called as Nissen's granule. Then nucleoplasm of this cytosol, it shows mitochondria. It also shows Golgi complex. It shows rough endoplasmic reticulum and Nissen's granule. Then what are dendrons? These are the short processes which carry impulse towards the cell body. Impulse means these are the electrical signal which are carried by this nerve cell. Here impulse reach to cell body through this dendron. Means dendron carry impulse towards the cell body. The next part is the axon. This axon, it consists of exoplasm. As the cell consists cell cytoplasm, in the same manner this axon, it consists exoplasm. And it is covered by axolemma. Axon is covered by axolemma. Next part, this axon, it may be with myelin sheath. Myelin sheath, it is a sheath of fatty material. It is a sheath of fatty material around this axon. It may be present or absent. If it is present, this neuron is called as myelinated. And if it is absent, it is called as non-myelinated. Or the next terms like medullated, if myelin sheath is present. Non-medullated, if myelin sheath is absent. The next sheath, it is the neurilemma, which it consists nucleus. This neurilemma and myelin sheath together, these are the parts of Schwann cell. Then this myelin sheath, it do not cover this axon. It leaves, where it is absent, that part is called as node of Ranvier. A part where myelin sheath is absent called as node of Ranvier. Then terminal end of this axon, it is branch. It is called as terminal arborization. Arbor means tree. This branching is like a tree branching, hence it is called as terminal arborization. It ends with telodendron. Here synaptic buttons are there, where neurotransmitter is stored. It may be acetylcholine or adrenaline, depending upon the type of neuron. Let's revise the structure of nerve cell. Two main parts are there. This is cytosol, or it is also called as pericardium, or it is also called as cell body. And processes. Short processes are dendron. A long process is there. That process is called as axon. then cell body, it consists nucleus, then micelles, granules are there, then nucleoplasm, it contains endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex and mitochondria. This axon, it may be surrounded by fatty sheath, myelin sheath. Then myelin sheath, it is covered by neurilemma, or which is also called as sheath of Schwann. This myelin sheath and neurilemma, these are the parts of Schwann cell. Then axon consists exoplasm, it is surrounded by exolemma. Part of axon where this myelin sheath is absent, that part is called as node of Ranvier. And this sheath of Schwann consists nucleus, which is called as nucleus of sheath of Schwann. And terminal part, it is the terminal arborization, which consists telodendron.